Rangers 0 Celtic 2 Tomas Rogic and Leigh Griffiths win Old Firm Derby for Hoops. The Hoops bossed this fixture last season with 5 wins, including 2-5-1 hammerings, and a draw in the 6 meetings between the sides, and Brendan Rodgers picked a team that knew what was required to triumph in this derby. And they did just that with a clinical display as second-half strikes from Tom Rogic and Leigh Griffiths ensured Celtic moved 8 points clear of their city rivals. While all of Celtic's starting 11 had played in this match before, in sharp contrast 7 of the side Pedro Caixinha selected were making their debuts, with 19-year-old Ross McCrorie impressing at the heart of their defence with a composed performance. Rangers will point to a first-half penalty appeal when Alfredo Morelos was caught by Jozo Simunovic, and Craig Gordon's stunning second-half save to deny the Colombian. But, in truth, the gulf between the two rivals remains as wide as ever. You never got the impression Rangers could get the better of last season's treble winners. Celtic started with a confidence befitting a side on a 56-game unbeaten domestic run and threatened in the first minute as Stuart Armstrong got away from Graham Dorans and slid the ball to Rogic, but his fizz drive was tipped over by Wes Foderingham. Then when Mikhail Lustig fouled Josh Windass just in front of the Gers' technical area, the midfielder clattered into Caixinha and took out his manager, who was able to see the funny side of it as he got back to his feet. Griffiths curled a free kick wide then spurned a great chance from a Kieran Tierney cross as he headed over. At this point the movement of Celtic's attacking players was causing Rangers all sorts of problems, pulling their defenders all over the place. Gradually, however, as the first half wore on Celtic's intensity dropped and Rangers began to pose a threat. The Light Blues had a big shout for a spot kick in the 14th minute when Windass flicked the ball to Morelos and Simunovic slid in on the striker. Simunovic didn't get anything on the ball but referee Craig Thompson wasn't interested. Then Simunovic was in the right place to cut out James Tavernier's low cross with Morelos waiting to pounce. Morelos broke down the left and cut back to Doran. The Gers skipper shifted the ball onto his left foot to get away from Brown but couldn't keep his shot down as it sailed over the crossbar. Morelos picked up a booking for a late challenge on Diedrich Boyata just before the break and Caixinha was raging at halftime when his striker didn't get a foul after being caught between the Hoops defender and Brown as they contested a high ball. Caixinha was shouting as the teams departed and when Brown stopped just in front of him, the pair eyeballed each other and the Gers manager had to be pulled away as heated words were exchanged. It may have been honors even in the first half but Celtic's class showed after the break. When Scott Sinclair jinked past Fabio Cardoso he cut back for Griffiths but his shot was deflected wide. However, any reprieve was only temporary as Celtic went ahead from the corner. Griffith's set piece was poor, but Rangers made a mess of clearing it and when it fell to Roberts, he scuffed a shot back into the box. With the home defense static, Rogic pounced to slam the ball into the roof of the net. As the Celtic fan celebrations died down, one supporter threw a flare onto the pitch which just missed Foderingham. Rangers were denied a leveler 5 minutes later by a wonderful reaction save from Gordon. Tavernier got onto Cardoso's pass and dug out a wonderful cross that sub Kenny Miller headed back into the danger area for Morelos. The hitman has bagged 8 goals this season but he was denied a 9th as his header was brilliantly blocked by the Celtic keeper. That was a massive moment in the game, and when Celtic doubled their lead after 65 minutes it was game over. Sub Callum McGregor pulled down the ball and gave it to Roberts, who cut inside and then played a through pass for Griffiths, who produced a clinical finish as he lashed a low shot beyond.